means of transport. Children, how do you go to school every day? By car, van, or motorbike? Cars, vans, motorbikes are means of transport. To transport means to move people or things from one place to another. We use many different means of transport. Let us see them one by one. Land transport. Means of land transport move either on roads or on tracks. Those which move on roads are called vehicles. And vehicles with engines are known as motor vehicles. Buses, cars, trucks, scooters, and auto rickshaws are some examples. Most of them run on petrol, diesel, or gas. Some run on electricity. Motor vehicles need roads. They also cost a lot of money. That is why people in villages and in places without proper roads, like in mountains and deserts, still ride animals or use carts drawn by animals. Transport that run on tracks are called trains. Trains carry people, goods, parcels, and letters over long distances. Those which carry only goods, such as coal, grains, and oil, are called good trains. A train has many coaches. The coaches are pulled by an engine called a locomotive. These days, locomotives run on diesel or electricity. Some coal-powered ones still run, mostly for tourists. The wheels of a train move on a set of tracks called railway. A tram looks a bit like a train and moves on tracks, but these tracks are laid on roads. Trams run on electricity. Kolkata is the only Indian city that has trams. A trolleybus runs on electricity, which it gets from overhead wires. Another system of train is called metro. A metro is a city's train system that runs mostly underground. Kolkata, Paris, London, Tokyo, and New York have such metros. In London, the metro is called the underground or the tube. In New York and other American cities, it is called the subway. In many cities, a train system running mostly above the ground is also called a metro. Cities like Delhi, Chennai, Mumbai, and Bengaluru have such metros. Children, do you know the London Underground is the world's oldest metro? Let us see water transport. Nobody knows when the first boat was made. The idea must have come from seeing logs float in water. To begin with, people must have carved out the middle of a log to make a boat. Later, they must have added oars to go faster and sails to get help from the wind. Until about 200 years ago, all ships had sails and were made of wood. Now, they are made of steel and have engines that run on oil. Not too long ago, people could cross the oceans only on ships. Ships called ocean liners carried people, goods, and mail from one port to another. Now that people can travel by air, these ships are used mostly for cruises and that is pleasure trips. Water transport is useful for transporting heavy goods, which planes cannot carry. It is also quite cheap. Container ships carry goods packed in large metal boxes called containers. Tankers carry liquids such as oil. Ships that carry fruits, vegetables, meat, and fish have huge refrigerators to keep the food fresh. A boat, a a launch, that is a large motorboat, or a ship that carries people over short distances is called a ferry. Some ferries also carry goods, vehicles, and even trains. Now look at air transport. The fastest way to travel is by aeroplane. The first plane was made only about 100 years ago. Today, there are large planes called airliners that carry passengers over long distances. These planes also carry cargo or goods. There are special cargo planes too, which carry only goods. A plane needs a long runway to take off and land. When we need to fly to a place that does not have a runway, we use helicopters. Helicopters can move straight up or down, so they do not need runways to take off and land. They can hover. Hover means stay at one spot in the air and even fly backwards.